Ladies and gentlemen, fighting in the three rounds of the bantamweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. His man is a mixed martial artist, weighing under 135 pounds. Fighting out of SBG Corp, presenting Florida
It's mine, motherfuckers! A fucking game! Fuck what you heard! It's what you're hearing! It's what you're hearing, listen! It's what you're hearing, listen! It's what you're hearing, listen! X gon' give it to ya! Fuck me, you can get it on your own! X gon' deliver to ya! Now open up the door, it's real! Hit the non-stop, my mind stays still! No hard getting busy with it!
As the opponent making his way to the cage, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a mixed martial artist, weighing in under 135 pounds. They have full power and then they presenting Elvis Luco!
Next Friday evening is proudly brought to you by KMS Sports. It is in the bantamweight division as Flobata Ferez out of SBG Cork takes on Full Power MMA, Elvis Luco. You could say, Andrew, a little less conversation and a little more action.
There we go again. 2-0. That's a 10-8. That's a 10-8 on the commentary scorecards.
I will not apologize for Elvis lyrics throughout this bout.
If I'm going to apologize for anything, it's for this walkout song, to be honest. Now it's good, but the intro was just a little bit too much for me.
I used to have a stat in my back pocket. I'm sure it's changed now, but anyone who walked out to Thunderstruck by AC/DC, there was something like an 82% loss rate to that song.
Oh, my goodness.
So whenever you heard a Thunderstruck, you go, uh-oh.
Didn't somebody break the Eminem curse in the UFC recently?
Yeah, that's right.
Eminem walkout tracks and notoriously led to defeats in the UFC over the years.
I have to say, I've never made the walk to the cage. If I did, I think it'd be Johnny Cash when the man comes around.
Really?
Yeah.
I liked Ring of Fire would be a good one, actually, I have to say. But I do like the idea of Darren Till last night when he walked out with nothing.
Yeah. Elvis Luco is in the white trunks and Ferz is in the black. Your third man in the cage, Mr. Aaron Wallace. We're underway. Nice stiff jab straight away by Ferz. And again, if you are watching earlier, this is not Eric back in the cage. This is his twin brother. A little look away by both men. And don't worry, your stream has not sped up. These are both lightning fast young fighters. Nice right hand by Ferz. Luco tried to fire back. And again, Elvis had a victory on Cage Conflict as well. So that'd be one aspect during this pandemic that the two Luco brothers had each other to train with.
Definitely.
He's in, steps across into full mount. Ferz trying to stop it, but excellent work by Elvis Luco. You could say he caught him in a trap.
Oh my God, no.
That's it, I won't do any more. Beautiful right hand.
One of these planned, it's brilliant. The Luco pace is something really, really impressive. Very good first round fighter.
And under the chin straight away. Elvis Luco looking to get it finished here.
He's going to get the one arm finish, I think.
This looks close. There's the tap. Beautiful work. Elvis Luco did not waste any time. Ultra impressive.
Great finish with the one arm choke. He got the four fingers across to the back of his bicep. And once he has that in, it's really hard. Hand fighting is easy when the hands are connected. But when the fingers are digging into the muscle and the skin, it can be much, much harder. And in that situation, you only have 2 or 3 seconds before you're tapping anyway.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Aaron Wallace, has called a stop for the action, and 1 minute and 3 seconds of round number one for your winner.